Yes, so I am Rakesh Jain from Gyanvar University. Today I am going to teach you about the working principle of full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier are of two types. First of all, we should know about the rectifier. A rectifier is a device, is a circuit which can convert the AC supply into DC supply. The main element of the rectifier is your diode. Rectifier are of two types. One is half wave rectifier and second one is full wave rectifier. Today I am going to teach you about the full wave rectifier. Basically the full wave rectifier the full wave rectifier are of two types. One is the full wave center tape rectifier and second one is the full wave bridge rectifier. Okay, so now just see this MS Paint file where I just write down full wave center tape rectifier first. So first of all, we just draw the circuit diagram of the rectifier. The key elements for any rectifier which we require for to draw the circuit is transformer, diodes and output load resistor. So I just use a transformer. Which transformer I should require for a center tape rectifier? I should require a center tape transformer. So this is the primary winding of transformer. Transformer is a device which convert the AC supply into AC supply. If its output is that lower than the input, then it is known as step down transformer. If higher, then it is known as step up transformer. So we require a step down transformer in which the input supply is your AC supply. So for the input, I just show you V in. That is your AC. This is your input side. Okay. Now we require to connect the diode. So here in full wave center tape rectifier, instead like the half wave rectifier, we require two diodes here instead of one diode like in half wave rectifier. So this is one diode and this is second diode. Okay, we just abbreviate their name as this upper diode name is D1, diode 1, that is diode 1, and this diode is diode 2. Now the diodes are connected with this transformer such that with the blue wire I am making the connection. The transformer upper side, upper winding is connected with the diode D1 and the lower wire is connected with the diode D. Both the terminal of these diodes, cathode terminal, we know that the diode terminal's name is, this one is known as anode and this one is known as cathode. This side is anode of these two diodes and this side is cathode of the diode. We can also say plus or minus. Anode is positive terminal of the diode and cathode is negative terminal of the diode. And then these cathode terminals are connected to the, together. After the connections, we should require the output that is taken out from the load resistor. So let it be load resistor. So the load resistors are connected with this diode's cathode terminals. So one side is connected with the short circuitry of cathode terminal and the transformer middle terminal is connected with the second terminal of the resistor. Here I put a jumper wire over there. It means these two wires are not in touch with each other. Now with that resistor we will find out the output. With that resistor, from that resistor we will find out the output. So then let the output voltage is abbreviated as V0. So this is the basic circuit diagram of the rectifier that is known as full wave center tape rectifier. Instead of two major difference between the circuitry of the half wave rectifier and full wave center tape rectifier is that in full wave center tape rectifier we should require a center tape transformer instead of the simple transformer like in a half wave rectifier, and the second thing, here we should require two diodes instead of a single diode like in half wave rectifier. Now for the working principle, in each diode, for working principle, we should require only two steps. One is the positive half cycle and second one is the negative half cycle. Let the input is V this one, that is your AC supply. So this one is lagged input. This is the signal peak representation of AC supply. Okay, in which with the orange color I am just showing you the positive half cycle, and the, with the green color I am showing you the negative half cycle. When I talk about the positive half cycle, it means I am talking about this side, the upper side, this one, this one, and this one. Okay, and when I am talking about the negative half cycle, it means I want to talk about this lower side. This one is negative half cycle. Okay. So first of all, the step number one for its working principle. Step number one during the time of positive half cycle. What will happen during the time of positive half cycle? First of all, we should redraw the circuit in this step. So I am going to draw the circuitry. Yes, this one is the circuitry. Now I am talking about the positive half cycle. It means the upper side is positive, because I am talking about the positive half cycle. So I just use the same orange color to show you the positive half cycle. The upper side is positive and the lower side is negative. It means this upper side is positive, then this middle side negative, again this one is positive and this one is negative. Don't be confused with that. Positive half cycle means the upper side is positive and the lower side is negative. Okay. So this one is the positive half cycle. Now what will happen with the diodes D1 and D2? Now see, this positive is directly applied to the connected with the anode terminal of the diode, and we know that whenever anode terminal is connected with plus and this negative is applied via this wire through this resistor to this cathode terminal. Okay, so it means cathode is negative, connected with the negative. Whenever anode is positive and cathode is negative, it means diode D1 becomes forward bias. So diode D1 becomes forward bias. D1 diode will be forward bias. I just write down for the forward bias FB. So you should understand the abbreviation. FB means forward bias. And what will happen with the diode D2 at this positive, during the time of positive half cycle? This negative is connected with the anode. So whenever negative is anode, it means cathode is connected with the positive. So whenever anode is negative, it means diode D2 becomes reverse bias. Whenever any diode anode is connected with the negative, it means diode is reverse bias. So D2 diode is reverse bias. I just put the abbreviation RB for the reverse bias. And we better know that whenever diode is forward bias, it means it will behave like a short circuit. And whenever diode is reverse bias, it means it will behave as a open circuit. It means what I mean to say, diode D1 is forward bias, so it will behave like a short circuit. So just a simple line, a wire is connected between each other. Okay. And D2 is reverse bias. It means open circuitry. It means open circuitry. So a wire which is not connected with each other. So what will happen at the output side, from this is short circuited, so whatever the positive is applied here will be as it is comes to the output point, because wire is totally connected with each other. See this with orange color. Wire start from this side of transformer, now short circuited due to diode is forward bias, and then connected to the resistor upper terminal. So directly the supply will be positive will be applied, and the negative is applied via this middle terminal. See this one, this one is totally connected. Now there is jumper wire, then connected with the resistor output side. It means at the output we will find out upper terminal as positive and negative terminal as lower terminal as negative. It means during the time of positive half cycle, we will as it is find out the positive output. We will as it is find out the positive. And there is no meaning of this diode D2, because that is open circuitry, so no signal will be passed from here. No signal will be passed from here. So as it is during the time of positive half cycle, we will find out the output at the output side, the positive ripples. Okay. So during the time of positive half cycle, I will find out the positive ripples. Now I am talking about the step number second. So step second is during negative half cycle. see what will happen during the line of negative cycle. Now first of all I should redraw the circuit. So this was my circuit of the full wave center type rectifier. We just redraw it. Now I am talking about the negative half cycle. It means with the green color I am showing you the negative half cycle. It means the upper terminal is negative and the lower terminal is positive. It means the upper terminal is negative and the lower terminal is positive. It means the middle terminal are just opposite to each other, because supply always consists of one terminal at plus, then the other terminal is definitely minus. Now, what will happen with the diodes? See, this negative terminal is connected with the anode. So, whenever anode terminal is negative, it means diode is reverse bias. So, diode D1 becomes reverse bias. So, D1 diode. Reverse bias. So I just put RB for the reverse bias for. Okay. And what will happen with the diode D2? See, this plus terminal is directly connected with the anode. So whenever plus is connected with the anode, it means diode will behave as a short circuit because it is forward bias. So diode D2 becomes diode is forward bias. Now what will happen? See very carefully. Because diode D1 is forward bias, so it will behave as a short circuit. Diode D1 becomes reverse bias, so it will behave as an open circuit. So diode D1 is reverse bias, open circuit. I just write an OC for the open circuit. Okay. And D2 diode is forward bias, so short circuit. So I just write an SC for the short circuit. Okay. So now I just remove the diode and represent the open circuit and short circuitry. Because diode D1 is reverse bias, so it is open circuitry, so a wire which is not connected with each other. And diode D2 becomes forward bias, so it is short circuit. So short circuit means a wire which is connected with each other. Now see, this is a negative half cycle. So I am talking about the negative perception. But what will I will find out at the output. Just see this one. So during the time of positive half cycle, I will find out the positive ripple. See, here upper terminal is plus and lower terminal is minus. It means positive half cycle. And at the output, during the time of positive half cycle, I will find out as it is the upper terminal is plus and lower terminal is minus. It means during the time of positive half cycle, I will find out the positive half cycle at the output. But what will happen with the negative half cycle? I provide here the upper terminal as negative and lower terminal as positive. It means it is negative half cycle. But what will I will find out at the output? See this one. See very carefully. This plus is connected. This plus is here. Then short circuited, so comes at here. Then goes to the upper terminal directly. It means the upper terminal is positive. Upper terminal will I find out as positive. And the upper terminal is positive, definitely the lower terminal will be negative. So it means during the time of negative half cycle, but I will find out at the output positive half cycle. Even the input is negative half cycle, but I will find out output as positive half cycle. So even the input is negative, but I will find out output as positive. So you just see the working principle, the complete working principle of full wave center tape rectifier. If you understand the total working principle, then write down in message box triple Y. So I understand that you understand the complete working principle of full wave center tape rectifier. If you understand the total working principle, then write down in message box. So it means at the output side, we only find out the positive ripples, even in the negative half cycle, even in the positive half cycle. Okay, so that is your full wave center tape rectifier working principle, that is totally completed. Now I am talking about, now I am going to explain you about the full wave bridge rectifier working principle. So see very carefully the full wave bridge rectifier working principle. See, just to save this file, we will open the new file, that is full wave bridge rectifier. Now my topic is full wave bridge rectifier, and we are going to explain you, I am going to explain you about the working principle of full wave bridge rectifier. See very carefully the working principle of this full wave bridge rectifier, because it is quite different from the other. Okay, now see. First of all, we should require the basic elements of any rectifier circuitry, that is transformer, diodes, and output load resistor. Here in case of full wave bridge rectifier, it consists, because the name imply consists the bridge word, it means it consists four arms in which diodes are connected, such that two diodes anode are connected, two diodes cathode are connected. Okay, now now see the screen of this MS Paint file in which I am going to explain you the full wave bridge rectifier. So this is for full wave bridge rectifier circuit. Okay, so I am going to start. First of all, as in the other rectifiers, we require a transformer. Here we don't require a center tape transformer, we require a simple transformer. So this is our transformer. And here we require four diodes actually, such that, let this is my first diode, which whose anode terminal is this one, cathode terminal is this one, let it, the name of this diode is D1. Second diode is this one, let it be D2, let the name of this diode is D2. Third diode is this one, name let be D3 name. And the fourth diode is this one. The diodes are arranged in a manner that two diodes anodes are connected with each other and two diodes cathode are connected with each other. So this is D4 diode. So the four diodes we should use, D1, D2, D3 and D4. And how they are connected? Now see very carefully. Two diodes anode terminals are connected. So these are anode terminals connected. Two diodes cathode terminals are connected. So these two cathode terminals are connected. Then they are connected with the output load resistor, so from which we will taken out the output. So they are connected with the resistor from which we will find out the output. So this is the resistor from which we will find out the output. So here I write down the output voltage as V0. Then the remaining terminals are connected with each other. One diode, diode D1 cathode and diode D3 anode are connected with each other and then connected to the transformer upper terminal. Okay. Diode D2 cathode and D4 anode are connected with each other and then connected with the diode. Sorry, transformer lower terminal with a jumper It means both wires are not touch with each other. So this is the basic circuit diagram of full wave bridge rectifier. Now I am going to explain you the working principle of this full wave bridge rectifier. Okay, now I am going to if you are able to see this MS Paint file screen, if you are able to see this screen, just type in message box yes. So I understand that you are able to see this screen. Okay, everyone is able to see this MS Paint file. Okay, no problem. So now see. Yes. Okay. Now see, this is the basic circuit diagram of full wave bridge rectifier. Now we know that the input side is always consists of the AC. This is the input side. So I just provide the voltage name as V input, like in the all cases. V input. So this is the transformer input side where I apply the input. Okay, and that is the output side. Now the input is AC. It means this one positive cycle, then negative cycle, positive cycle, then negative cycle, positive cycle, then negative half cycle, and so on. This is continuous. So with the orange color, I am showing you the positive cycle. So this one is positive cycle. This one is positive cycle. This one is positive cycle. Okay. And with the green color, I am showing you the negative cycle. So this one is negative cycle. This one is negative cycle. This one is negative cycle. Now we should focus on the working principle. So there are two steps for any diode. Step number one is during positive cycle. During positive cycle. Now see that what will happen during the time of positive cycle. First of all, we should redraw the circuit. So I just copy and paste this circuit. So this is my circuit diagram. Okay, so positive half cycle, it means upper terminal is, I am going to explain you with this orange color, upper terminal is positive and lower terminal is negative. See very carefully, upper terminal is positive, lower terminal is negative. Now see, this positive is applied at this terminal. It means diode D1 cathode is positive and diode D3 anode is positive. Okay. Similarly, this negative is applied via this wire to here. It means diode D2 cathode is negative and diode D4 anode is negative. Now, as per the rule, whenever this diode D1, what will happen with this diode D1? See very carefully, diode D1. Because the cathode is positive, it means it is reverse bias. It is reverse bias. So I just write down RB, reverse bias. Reverse bias. So what will happen? So it is open circuit. So it is open circuit. Okay. So this will happen with the diode D1. Diode D1 cathode is positive. It means it is reverse bias. So open circuit. You should understand. If anode is positive and cathode is negative, it means forward bias. If cathode is positive, it means reverse bias. It means bidirectly anode is negative. Okay. Now what will happen with this diode D3? Now see with this here, I am talking about what will happen with this diode D3. Because anode is positive, it means it is forward bias. So diode D3 becomes forward bias. And whenever any diode is forward bias, it means it is short circuit. So I just put the abbreviation SC for the short circuit. So B3 is short circuit here because it is forward bias. Now what will happen with this diode D2? I am showing you right down here. See this one very carefully. What will happen with this diode D2? Because cathode is negative, it means it is also forward bias. Because cathode is negative, so it is forward bias. So whenever diode is forward bias, so short circuit. It will become short circuit. Okay. Now what will happen with this diode D4? Now see here, what will happen with this diode D4? Because anode is negative, so diode is reverse bias, so open circuit. So open circuit. So I am just writing down here, reverse bias for the working principle of any diode, you should clear in your mind that when the diode is open forward bias and when reverse bias, when open circuit, when short circuit. Any diode is short circuited whenever it is forward bias. Any diode is open circuited whenever it is reverse bias, first of all. And when it is forward bias, reverse bias, if anode is positive, then forward bias. Anode is negative, means reverse bias. Cathode is negative, it means forward bias. Cathode is positive, it means reverse bias. Very simple. Okay, so now we understand that diode D1 and diode D4 are reverse bias, so they are open circuit. So we just remove this diode D1 because it is open circuited, and diode D4 is also open circuited. So we just remove these two diodes. A wire which is not connected with each other. No meaning of this bias. Okay. Now what happens with the diode D3 and diode D2? Both are forward bias, so they will behave as a short circuited. They will behave as a short circuited. So now they are short circuited. A wire which is connected with each other. See very carefully the working principle of this rectifier. So both are forward bias, so short circuit. Okay, now what we'll find out at the output? We are talking about the positive up cycle. It means only the positive ripples we should focus on. Okay, now what we will find out? See, here the positive side is completed, comes here. It will not able to go there because the wire is disconnected, but it will go here. And the upper side of the output, it will reach at the upper side of the output. So upper side is positive at the output side. Now see the lower side. This negative signal is comes here, then go here. Here the negative, but it will not able to go there because it is open circuited. So it will go here. See very carefully. It will go here, then connect here, then comes at the downside, then goes to the output side. So the output lower side is negative. Whenever upper side is positive and lower side is negative, it means we will find out at the output the positive ripples, positive upcycle. So during the time of positive upcycle, we will find out as it is the positive ripples. Okay. Now we are talking about the second step. See very carefully. Now we are talking about the second step, that is during the time of negative half cycle, what will happen? Now see very carefully the negative half cycle step, that is second step. What will happen during the time of negative half cycle? First of all, just redraw the circuit. So I just copy and paste the circuit with here. The lack of space, so I just and just here. Okay, now see. During the time of negative upcycle, it means I am talking about the lower side. The green color I am showing you. The upper side is negative, the lower side is positive. The upper side is negative, the lower side is positive. Okay. So negative half cycle, it means I am talking about the negative side. Negative. Now what will happen, we will see. This negative will be comes here and applied to both sides. So diode D1 cathode is negative and diode D3 anode is negative. Okay. Now this positive comes here, goes to here. Okay. So diode D2 cathode is positive and diode D4 anode is positive. So what will happen with each diode? See very carefully. First of all, I am talking about diode D1. So because the cathode is negative, it means it is forward bias, it means short circuit. So diode D1 becomes forward bias. Whenever cathode is positive, reverse bias. When cathode is negative, forward bias. So forward bias, so short circuit. So diode D1 become short circuit. Okay. What will happen with this diode D3? Now see very carefully, because the anode is negative. So whenever the anode is negative, it means reverse bias, open circuit. So reverse bias. So what will happen with this diode B2 and D4? Now see very carefully. I'm talking about this diode D2. So what will happen with this diode D2? Because the cathode is positive, it means reverse bias. So open circuit. Whenever cathode is positive, it means reverse bias. Now I'm talking about this diode D4. Now see this diode. Diode D4. So diode D4 anode is positive. Whenever anode is positive, it means forward bias. So short circuit. Okay. So we understand about all those four diodes. Which one is open circuit? Which one is short circuit? There. So just open circuit diode. Remove the wires. So because reverse bias. So it is open circuited. So there is no meaning of this diode. A wire which is disconnected. And also the diode D3 is reverse bias, so open circuited, so we just remove this wire which is not connected with each other. Now what will happen with this diode D1? D1 is short circuited because it is forward bias. So forward bias, so short circuited, it means a wire which is connected with each other. Like this one. Okay. And diode D4 is also short circuited, so a wire which is connected with each other. Yes, now see about the CD signal. Because the upper side is negative, it comes here. Now see very carefully. Here it will not go because open circuited, but here it will go. See very carefully. This negative side comes here, then connected with this, then go to lower side, then connected with the lower terminal. Even the upper at the input side, the upper terminal is negative, but at the output we will find out the lower terminal is negative. And what will happen with this plus? Now see, this positive side is connected with here. Now it jumper wire then goes to here, then connected with the upper terminal. Okay, so upper side we will find out a positive. So during the time of negative half cycle at the input, but at the output we will find out the positive half cycle. So during the time of negative half cycle even, we will find out the positive half cycle. So the complete circuitry, the complete waveform will show you like this one. See very carefully. The complete waveform is this one. During the time of positive half cycle of the input, we will find out the positive half cycle. During the time of positive half cycle, we will find out as it is the positive half cycle. And even during the time of negative half cycle, we will find out the positive half cycle. So the waveform of this full wave bridge rectifier is the same like the full wave center type rectifier, a continuous positive response. Okay. So that's all about the working principle of full wave center type rectifier, full wave bridge rectifier. I think you understand about the basic working principle of these diodes. And it is very easy to understand the working principle. So yesterday I taught you about the half wave rectifier working principle, and we prove that the waveform is as it is which we drawn. And today we prove that what kind of waveforms we will find out at the output of full wave center type and full wave bridge rectifier. So the working principle of half wave rectifier, full wave center type rectifier and full wave bridge rectifier is completed. So I, Rakesh Jain from Gyanvir University, want to thanks you to watch this video. Kindly like and subscribe and comment over that video. Thank you very much.